Handy Harry slipping and sliding. Oh yeah, right hand. So this, can listen to this sound. This action doesn't make much sound. Sometimes you hear thump, 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 thump. You hear the key come up. Look at it. It doesn't make any sound, for God's sake. Oh, there, now I can hear it. You hear thump, 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 thump. So that's this, that's what this exercise is. And it's amazing how fast it can go and not make any noise. And it went pretty quickly, but there was no sound. So that's this one. And then you can do it in such a way where the black notes are held down too. And you can do it in such a way where the thumb is hanging down here instead of being here. Yeah. Oh. Wait a minute, slide for it. So then this variation is to do this. That's a strange variation. I don't even know.
The purpose for the young student of this exercise? Just getting in contact, or?
There's a lesson, Moshe Feldenkrais lesson in the Esalen Institute series, where you stand and you have to touch here, touch here, and touch here, and touch here. It's all bending the body to touch. But he has the whole lesson, you have to rub the hand down here, and rub the hand down here, rub the hand down here, rub the hand down here. And I always ask myself, why do you have to rub the hand? Lesson is about flexing the torso and rotating the torso and all the hamstrings. Why rubbing the hand? Well, have you ever done this? Rub this part of the finger. Rub the finger like this, and now rub the palm. Where is there more sensation? In the palm. Right. The palm, the sensory nerves in the palm are more richly packed than just anywhere else in the body, virtually. And so when you actually have physical contact with the palm, the entire hand is woken up from the inside.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And if you look at an x-ray, there's the three phalanges and the metacarpal, but on the x-ray it looks like all this is the finger, all this is the finger, all this is the finger. And so stimulating the palm, all of a sudden the metacarpal bones are felt inside the hand, and they start to individuate. So you'll actually notice, look at these two metacarpal bones. Mm-hmm. You need a friend to do this one. And look at these two. Oh, look, these two, they bend in on each other. Even these two bend on each other. And when you find all the metacarpal bones bending, you can find that the thumb metacarpal can almost touch the fifth metacarpal. They bend in
mm-hmm.
so
okay.
And there's one of the arches in the hand, the fourth arch in the hand is this arch. It's the wrist. The wrist is not flat. The wrist is a arch. Those eight bones in the wrist, they don't go flat across like that, they go like this.
Okay.
Yeah. And so
why the fourth? The one, two?
Oh. The first arch. The first arch is the Russian arch from the fingertip to the wrist. And here's the keystone. The second arch is the transverse arch across the knuckles and down, and that's again the keystone. The third arch is the Roman arch. It's between the second and the thumb, and again it's the keystone. But I call it Roman because it has a flat top. It doesn't have it. And then the fourth arch is this one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So actually the fourth arch is a mirror. It's two parallel arches.